For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Again, we bring to you Jesus Christ. We bring to you the means of God to be saved by the one that said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. We speak about death, and death will happen. And if you were here last week and able to hear the message this week, God in his long suffering has given you 7 more days to repent of your sins to get right. And yet death will come one day for you. Death will come at 1 hour. The hour we do not know. The time that we don't know. In that, God has proclaimed to his creation, man, that you need a means to be saved.
Speak softly and carry a big stick.
Your means of salvation is through Jesus Christ, the finished work upon Calvary, the death of Jesus Christ according to the scriptures, the entombment of Jesus, and the resurrection 3 days and 3 nights later, all according to the scriptures.
Hey, Dan.
In God, in the Word of God, God says, go ye all into the world and preach the gospel. Tell them what they do not want to hear. Do it in such a foolish way, but of the powerful way of the gospel, that it is able to save your soul. If you were to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. And when God says, go into the world and preach the gospel, that takes your religion out. Because God would not give you a warning about salvation through the blood of Jesus Christ if your religion was okay and a mean standard to get to glory. If you were so good enough to get to God on your own merits, then why did Jesus Christ have to suffer and die for you? And you have the nerve to think that you are better than Jesus when you think you can come to God with what you believe will get you to heaven outside of Jesus Christ and his finished work. And since Jesus is God and God is Jesus, you are telling God that his sacrifice is not good enough, but you are. You may say, oh, I will never say that. When you expect to get to a glory on what you have done outside of Jesus Christ, you are lifting up yourself over Jesus Christ. And even if you were saying, hey, I don't believe in God, I don't believe in heaven, I don't believe in hell, and still you're saying whatever you believe happens to you when you die is much better than the Word of God and the finished work of Jesus Christ. Because you are saying, hey, I don't believe in God, so you are better than God. There's no heaven or hell since you making God a liar, because the Bible says there is a heaven and there is a hell. And yet the Bible says there is none that doeth good. No, not one. Again, you defy the scriptures. When the scriptures say one thing and you do or believe another, you think you are better than God. And those are terrible odds. When Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and you means come to God by something other than Jesus Christ, you make yourself more important, you make yourself better than God and the Word of God. Because you are telling the one that says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, I got something better. You are telling the way, the truth, and the life, I'm better. Because there is no better but Jesus Christ. But in your eyes, and in your belief, and what you think, is going to pass off what God will approve, even though it defies the scriptures, the Holy Bible. You cannot find anywhere religion gets God's credit. It doesn't even get half a credit. And the only degree you will get with your religion is a billion degrees of lake of fire that burneth forever. That will be your degrees. And we stand here for the reason is that you are going to die, and yet after death there is an afterlife, there is a place of torment, there is a place of judgment, the wrath of God, if you do not believe on Jesus Christ. And we sit here to forewarn you that you must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. You must be born again. And yet you mock and ridicule and thumb your nose up at what God has to say. Listen, I am not saying my words. These are the words from the King James Bible that you must be born again. You must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. And yet God, in His free will, in His long suffering, has given you the option to choose where you go. And you're not safe without Jesus Christ. You're not safe hiding in atheism. I'll just believe there's no God. You ain't safe. The God of the Bible says, the fool has said in his heart, there's no God. I think religion. I think my church. Will get me into God, and churches are closing. Across this nation, churches are closing its doors. What do you do then? You walk up to your place of salvation, you turn the door handle, and it's locked, and now it's a beauty salon. My preacherette, my priest can get me through. I rely on Reverend so-and-so, Dr. so-and-so, idiot so-and-so, and that person dies and buried in the ground. Where's your hope? Chip out at that grave, he's going to stay in that ground. He's going to stay dead. Where's your hope with that? That man that you think is so important in the ministry, he's a sinner just like you. He can't do nothing for you. No hope in that. Well, see, sir, you understand, I was baptized, and baptism can get me saved. I'm going by baptism, salt water or fresh water? Baptism with fluoride, baptism with no fluoride. Cold water, hot water. Fire hydrant, river, ocean, sea, gold, what kind of water? If baptism can save you, the Bible would say this kind of water, that kind of place. And yet nowhere in the pages of the Bible does baptism save you. that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God's love, the love of God, the message of God's love is upon Calvary, upon the cross. When Jesus Christ suffered and died, was nailed to that cross. That is God's love, John 3:16. And that is the message that we bring to you, that with the suffering of God. The suffering of God. That you may not suffer in eternal life.
Nobody listening to him. This is not the way to get people to listen.
Well, they hear. Plenty of people hear. They all can hear. I know they can hear. You see, Jesus Christ suffered that you might not suffer. And without Jesus Christ, when you die, the Bible speaks about a place of torment forever. And you need not to go because Jesus Christ already suffered, Isaiah 53, for our iniquity, for our sin. But if you choose to pay for your own sin, you will do that in hellfire for all eternity. You will suffer for your own sins. Besides, the fact is that Jesus Christ had already suffered. He already died. He already conquered death. He already conquered Satan. By the gospel that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures, and was buried, and arose again the third day, according to the scriptures. That is the word that's proclaimed. That is the message of the feet that please God when they bring the gospel, Romans chapter 10. For thou shalt believe with thy heart and confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be saved, Romans chapter 10. You don't come to God with Mary. You don't come to God with any other man but Jesus Christ. Behold the man. What will you do with Jesus? Death will come. Be more assured. Death is more assured than taxes. And the more assurance of death is, if you were to die without Jesus Christ, according to the Bible, you will burn in the devil's hell forever. And it's even longer forever because there is no time in eternity. Your lapse in the afterlife without Jesus Christ is torment. No relief. The message for you is not old 666 Antichrist. The message is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. How many people, as of right now, this AM, this morning, has died and gone off into eternity? And they had plans today. They had a to-do list, and it was not on their list to die. And many of you here in Daytona Beach Farmers Market, it is never to be on your list to trust Jesus, that this guy just needs to shut up and go away and leave us alone in our commerce. And yet, death will come to your list. Death will come to the top of your list and you will die. And if you die without Jesus, it will be hell. And according to the Bible, let's be true. Let's be honest. Hell is not forever. Because the Bible says in Revelation 20, fire. You will be in hell, and then you'll be the lake of fire that burneth forever. And you don't come out. And imagine hearing while in hell, Jesus saves, and you did not adhere. You see, when Jesus told us about the rich man in hell, Jesus reminded us that the rich man had memory. You will remember in hell in agony, in tragedy. It's not a tragic event to be shot dead at a concert. It is a tragic to die and end up in hell forever. You can be shot on the streets of America and receive Christ on a hospital bed. But if you die in America without Jesus Christ, you will burn in hell. And the Bible says that that's torment. And it could happen right here in Daytona Beach. It can happen anywhere where you are, death. You gotta wake up and realize that the Bible is correct and you are wrong. Prophecies of the Bible, 100% with God, nothing less, nothing more. And a prophecy in the Bible is you will die, the wages of sin is death. And without Jesus Christ, you will burn in hell. That's a prophecy being fulfilled every day. And you need not fulfill that prophecy. The prophecy of believing on the Lord Jesus Christ at death will be present with the Lord. Absent from the body, present with the Lord if you're saved. If you're saved and your time comes and death knocks on your door, welcome death, come death, take me death, and to be with Jesus Christ forevermore. And yet, if without Jesus Christ, the torments of hell. You gotta preach hell, because hell is present, hell is alive, hell is full, and getting fuller. Hell is a reality. And yes, my friend, Jesus preached about hell. You just have not read your Bible. And if you got a perverted, worldly Bible that's not by God, it will say Hades. Hades is hell. Just how it's conditioned. But there's no electricity in hell. There's no AC in hell. There's no relief in hell. The Bible says the word of God, H-E-L-L. And the worst words you can ever hear is God telling you to go to hell. Man will tell man, go to hell. According to the Bible, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. When you depart from the presence of God, you are in the wrath of God. For he that has the Son has everlasting life. He that has not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. And John the Baptist tells us that the wrath of God is hell. And you don't need to go. I wish I could be louder. I wish I could have a voice that Daytona Beach could hear, the wonderful words of Jesus. You can hear those morons at the speech center. Why not hear about Jesus Christ on the house? when you end up in hell by hearing the gospel being preached up to you, it's your foolishness, not mine. It is your fault, not mine. And if you reject Jesus Christ and say, I reject that man, I reject that Bible, I reject everything about God. I say, don't, but if you do, in your views against the rebellion against God and His Word, you will stand before God, you will bow the knee, and you will say, Jesus Christ is Lord, as you are cast in the lake of fire forever. You will proclaim Jesus is Lord. Do it now while you're breathing and living. Don't do it after you're dead. Because when you do it after you're dead, it won't be doing in hope. It will not be done in righteousness. It will be done that you will do your own sins in the lake of fire that burneth forever. Oh, if more men that were saved would do what I'm doing out there in the streets of America. If more men would faithfully preach the Bible, if you were to put the Bible back into school, put the Bible back in the courtroom, you would have a change. Democrats can't save you. Republicans can't save you. Only Jesus can save. America's a nation that's divided. It does not want God. It does not want Jesus Christ. And you are reaping, you are sowing the seeds that this country has planted. You're not going to turn your back from God and the Bible and reap wonderful, great things. It's only going to get worse. But if you were to believe on Jesus, I say now, but if you were to believe on Jesus, the peace, the hope, the patience, the long-suffering, the love of God, the joy of God, and you're not going to taste of God and the Holy Spirit until you believe first. Don't sit there at your booth and say, oh, I just had a feeling that the Lord will just come and move through me. And I do the hokey pokey and turn myself from, that ain't gonna work, my friend. Jesus already told us that the world cannot receive the Holy Spirit. You are not going to get the filling of the Spirit until you believe on Jesus Christ. You can mumble, jumble, and hope all you want. Unless you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. Thou shalt receive that Holy Spirit, the Comforter. I'll tell you something else what the Bible says. If you reject Jesus Christ, God does not love you. When you reject Jesus Christ, God rejects you. Don't say God bless you when you sneeze as a sinner rejecting Jesus Christ. He's not going to. Even John the Apostle told us about Godspeed, God bless you, and all that. Be warned. You see, there's a lie out there. God hates the sin, but loves the sinner. That's a lie. God loves the sinner, past tense, John 3:16, at Calvary. That's the love of God on the sinner at Calvary. Now you walk up to Calvary, and you see that bleeding, you see that man that's been torn in pieces, God loves me. You're a fool. When you woke up to Jesus on the cross and say, Jesus, I am better than you, and you expect God to love you, you're a fool. And your church is a fool. And your pastor's a fool. And they preach that God loves rejecters of Jesus Christ. You're a fool. And you tell them I said that. There is no love outside of Jesus Christ. There is no spirit of the fruit of love of the Comforter until you receive Jesus Christ as your Savior. Love is a fruit of the Spirit. The Spirit is received by those that receive Jesus Christ. See the problem? Without Jesus Christ, you have received an unholy Spirit. Paul said that there's another Jesus. There's another Spirit. And there's another gospel. You may have the gospel that God loves everybody. And that's a lie. The only way God would love you is when you come to that cross and you drop on your knees and you repent of your sins and you put it all upon the finished work of Jesus Christ. Then the love of God will come into you. Then that Comforter will step inside you. By the finished work of Jesus Christ alone. That moment you receive Jesus, that's when the Holy Spirit will come into you. And at that moment, you'll start to see, hey, that guy is right. I can't believe that that guy was right. How come I couldn't see that until now? Why couldn't I see the truth? Because you have not believed on Jesus to receive the Holy Spirit. That's in the Bible. You see, you're being blinded by Satan, 2 Corinthians 4:4 right now. The seed is being planted and Satan is grabbing that seed. But if you were to taste of the Lord and receive of that Holy Spirit at Calvary by the finished work of being raised from the dead the third day and the third night, if you were to put your faith and trust on that, you will see that the Lord is good and you are loved. But don't you dare walk up to Jesus Christ and say, I don't want you, then expect God to love you. There is no love of God outside of only believing on Jesus Christ to be saved. God does not love you when you reject Jesus Christ. God doesn't love you when you come to Him with religion. And how can God love you if you're an atheist? I'm just trying to preach the truth here. We need more truth in the streets of America. Because you're not going to find them in most places. The love of God is that Jesus Christ suffered and died for you. Now get up and believe on Him. Get up and put your sins in the Lamb of God who's taken away the sin of the world. For the wages of sin is death. You will die. But the gift of God's eternal life is Jesus Christ is the Lord. Now hold on for a minute. The gift of God. Put your money away. It's free. It's not nothing you can be. It can be bought.
Fuck you. Okay. I'm sick of hearing this shit every fucking week. You're being a real fucking asshole, man.
For God so loved the world, even this gentleman here, if he were to believe on Jesus, he'd be saved. Now, salvation is free. There's no cost. Come to Jesus Christ by faith. Put your sins upon the Lamb of God to be saved.
or die.
Is that what the best the world can do? Hey, you're so faithful. Thank you for being here. And can't say the rest of the words. But all the words in the Bible, I commit. I could stand up and read the Bible to you. Pure, clean words. The pure word of the Lord Jesus Christ is that He is able to save you. You must come to Him before you die. And yes, it's the same message every week. Because you will not believe the first message. The messages don't change until you believe.
Thank you for being here so much. When I come here on Saturday, I have got to see you guys. You are amazing.
Thank you. You are not going to get any other message until you receive the message that Jesus saves. No Jesus, no salvation, no more into the Bible, but Jesus saves. That's it. It do me no good to preach anything else but the salvation of Jesus Christ, and you rejected Him. I have great testimony because one man says no one hears us. And another man comes up and says it's the same message every week. Thank God you can hear. Thank God you know that Jesus saved. Thank God it's put into your ears. It's been planted in your heart. Believe it or not, I like a gentleman that came up like that because I know the seed of God has been planted in his heart and Satan did not take it away. You that just walk on, you're the ones I'm frightened about. That's where Satan is taking the seed. Just go on. But your message as lost sinners is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's not going to change. I will tell you when it will change. I'll be honest. The moment after the church is raptured, then that salvation message will change. But we're not going to go into that because right now Jesus Christ saves. Right now the message is the gospel that Jesus Christ died for your sins according to the scriptures and was buried and rose again the third day according to the scriptures. That's the message. That's the same message that was preached on April 21st, 1987 to a hell-bound sinner. That's the same message that was preached to me in 1987. What's up there? I don't see anything up there. I don't know why he told me to look up, bud. Nothing. And that message was good enough for a sinner to receive Christ and stand here and preach the same message. I don't know how many years it's been. I'm not good at math. But 1987, 2017, it's the same message. Receive Christ as your Savior to be saved, to be in the merit and love of God, Jesus Christ alone. It's the same message. And only by Jesus Christ. Jesus said the same message. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I'm not going to change you. The only access to God is by me, said Jesus. I'd be a fool to preach something else. This message I will preach at the farmer's market. This message I'll preach at a bunch of motorcyclists. This message I'll preach at college students. This message I will preach to people going to a racetrack. This message I will sit at a farmer's market. This message I'll talk to men in prison. Because it's the message that saves a soul from hell. message going to most of the churches in America tomorrow morning. It's in Corinthians. I forget what the passage is. But even Paul says that there are Satan's messengers behind the pulpits. Isn't there something wrong? When you want to change, as America has changed for the worse, and yet the gospel's the same. It has been always Jesus saves. And Jesus already told us in the scriptures, I've preached this message multiple times. Proverbs 1, you're going to scorn it, you're going to rebuke it, you're going to hate it, you're going to ignore it, you're going to be many that go the broad way. You don't surprise me. You want to surprise me? Step forward, right now. Come forth and put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. That will surprise me. It would be good to see someone receive Christ and come back next week with us to be preaching too. If a man to receive Christ today and come back next week and say, hey, listen, I give him this microphone and the Bible and say, go for it, brother. You're a new babe in Christ. Go for it. I guarantee he would preach the same message I've been preaching every single week. Please, my heart's getting convicted. Stop it, stop it, stop it. But Jesus says, there's nothing else. There's nothing more. Jesus says, he sure is not ruining your business. We got a lot of people come up today. Great message, great to see you guys out. Because for them, it's the power of what we're preaching, the message of Jesus Christ. For you, I preached this 2 weeks ago, for you it's foolishness. I guess he wasn't here. But notice what name I keep preaching. Uh-oh. The plastic bags are ruining Mother Earth. Oh, a fish is going to swallow them. Warning, warning. Jesus saves. Never mind the plastic bags. Never mind the whales. Get your soul saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. That's what you need to worry about. It's your eternal soul. You will live forever. Now, what you choose to do with Jesus will decide where you go in the eternal life. And without Jesus Christ, it will be hell.